First of all, guys, don't do what I did with someone else's drone.
Hey, peeps, my name is Ilya, and welcome to the vlog. We come out here to fly the drone. The other day I was talking with a friend of mine. Well, I never actually met him, but I am looking to that beer. His name is Alf. He is a colleague of mine, a photographer and filmmaker. We were watching a video. We're like, you know, this is pretty dope, but it's not enough to just have a drone and know how to lift it off to make cinematic shots. So I got out here having in my mind a bunch of different shots. I actually drew it out on a piece of paper. It's like a matrix of all the different types of moves you can do with a drone to make a more cinematic shot, all the way from like just standing still and looking at something to making really complex shots with, like, you know, lifting and you'll see. So I'm not gonna talk any rubbish. I'm gonna dive right into the different types of motions you can do with your drone. Obviously, the first thing is just staying static. That's literally the same as putting your camera on a really tall tripod. Used to emphasize stability or smoothness or kind of calming shots where you don't wanna have much camera movement, which is fine. You can do a time lapse or something with a drone as well. But generally, if you want to make a dynamic, interesting video, you don't really want to use that shot. So obviously, one of the easiest things you can do with your drone is pan it, as in rotate or spin it around in a circle. So literally, the drone is still staying in one place and you're rotating around, looking around you. It's an okay establishing shot, but again, because the camera is almost mounted on a tripod, lots of TV crews use that because they have huge cameras and they have to mount them on big sturdy tripods. But those shots look really boring because they're absolutely everywhere and have been for hundreds of years. So if you can, try to avoid a regular panning shot. Same thing goes for tilting. If you tilt your camera up and down, you're just panning in a vertical direction. So just panning your camera can do a reveal, but there are so many more interesting ways that you can do that. Now we can start moving. So first of all, we have the dolly shot, which is moving forwards or backwards. This is very simple. You just move your drone forward, but because the camera is moving and it's smooth, you can get some really amazing push-in shots where you're trying to focus on a certain subject, or maybe you can move backwards, which helps reveal the background and the surroundings. Same goes for the trucking shot, going side to side. You can either be following someone or revealing a part of the landscape or the subject that you haven't seen before. These are very simple and they work okay, but we're gonna get into ways of how you can improve them and make them cooler. And of course, we have the jib, which is moving up and down or changing your altitude. Using it on its own, again, is just one directional movement, but it's a great way to, for example, show your subject first and then go up and show your surroundings. Those are the five basic elements that you can use. And now we're gonna start combining them 2x2 and then 3x3, and then you have the fancy shots when you combine them all, and those are really difficult. So we have the pan and tilt, which is pretty much you spinning around and moving your camera up and down. Again, the drone stays in one spot, so the camera is not moving. You don't have any depth because the foreground and the background is moving at the same speeds. It's more interesting than using any of those two alone, but again, there are fancier ways to get around filming something like this. Then we have the pan and jib, which is literally you moving up and turning at the same time. Again, it's a lot more interesting than just either of those alone. Because of the jib motion, you do have the depth perception as the foreground moves faster than the background, but also you get the rotation to reveal the length and vastness of whatever you're looking at. Then we combine the pan and the dolly. So you're moving forward and you're rotating. I call this the FPV shot because pretty much where you rotate the drone is gonna continue moving forward. So you're pretty much flying inside a computer game and controlling where you're going. That's okay, I guess, if you're following a path, maybe a winding road or a running trail. It works. And now we get to the pan and truck combination. I absolutely love this. This is one of my favorites and it's pretty simple to do. You fly in one direction and you rotate the camera in the other direction. It's gonna take a while to get the hang of the speeds because you want to be moving as fast as you can, but the rotation has to be pretty slow. But what's cool about this is because the foreground and the background are moving much faster than the middle, you can isolate all the unneeded things and really focus on the object at the center of the frame. Getting your viewers attention to what you want them to is one of the most powerful tools a storyteller can have, which is why this shot is among the top three for sure. Then we have the tilt and jib shot, which is you changing altitude but also tilting your camera. This is cool, and I can imagine it used in like outro sequences or when you're waving goodbye or something, because the drone is moving up into space but also tilting the camera to follow the subject that is focused on. Great for closing shots. Then we have the tilt and the dolly, which is, for example, you moving forward and tilting your camera downwards. I call this the helicopter shot because you're flying over a subject but you're also tracking them with a camera. It gives you great motion and foreground and background separation, but also lets you track, you know, what's important in the frame. Then we have the tilt and truck, which is moving sideways but also tilting the camera. This can be cool if you're, for example, side following a person or a vehicle and you're really zoomed in on them, but as you move, you tilt the camera up to show the surroundings in the background, for example. All these shots work to either reveal or hide something depending on how you as the storyteller use the shot. Now we have the jib and dolly combination, which is almost like the dolly, but instead of just moving forwards, you're also gaining altitude. It just adds another dynamic to the shot, which can make it more interesting. Maybe someone's walking up a staircase or a vehicle's driving up a hill. You can maintain a close distance but also keep following them as the drone is flying forward and rising. And the jib and truck is almost kind of like the tilt and truck. You may be following something sideways, but instead of just tilting your camera, you also move up and maybe backwards at the same time, and you get another way of changing from something close up and focused on object to an establishing shot. If you combine dolly and truck, you get a diagonal movement. It is okay, it is still a one-directional movement because both the dolly and the truck is in the same plane, so you're pretty much just moving diagonally, which could be more interesting because it's a lot more rare to see that type of movement in most productions. Those are the 10 possible combinations out of 5 elements that you have, and after this it's a combination of 3 or more of these controls. Now the options after this are limitless, so I haven't made a specific list, but once you get the basics of these down, you can start combining more and get some really fancy shots which have all of these controls built into it. You don't even have to use them at the same time. You can use a combination of several and then a combination of others, and you can make really cool shots of flying around, changing altitudes, moving your camera, and really making it look like a helicopter shot. And on the Mavic Pro, you don't even have the zoom feature like you do on the Mavic Zoom, which adds a 6th element on top of all of this. So you can really go crazy with the things you can do with this if you just try to think a little bit out of the box and train yourself to do something more complex than the easiest thing, which pretty much anyone can do. As always, it's the practice that makes it perfect, because the controls are really sensitive if you want to have those smooth motions, especially if you're not rotating and you want to start rotating. You don't want to just rotate at the same time. You have to be very slow with the rotation as it's starting out to get that smooth intro. That's it, guys. I hope there were a couple tips for you here that you could pull out for yourself on your piloting skills. If you're not a drone pilot, what can I say? Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to see you in the next video. So many cool lights. So many cool lights.